What is up, everyone? You know what time it is. My name is KG and I'm back with another video. I'd like to take a few minutes today and talk to you about the leadership crisis in Africa. Africa remains in disarray and in severe impoverishment, while our leaders, who are supposed to be putting their heads together in a constructive manner to rebuild this continent, continue to hail insults at each other in various parliaments. Colonial powers have done a great job in dividing us to the extent that, even though colonialism in the original sense is no longer in place, its clutches still have us, and they manifest in the form of economic inequalities and the manner in which we see and interact with one another as a people. The myriad of issues enveloping this continent are too many for our leaders to be wasting time fighting each other instead of uniting. It is said that a house divided in itself can never stand. Nothing could be further from the truth. It is time for our leaders to put aside their egos and realize that Africa is in desperate need of unity and oneness of vision. It has always been one of the key objectives of the colonial powers to divide us so that they can conquer us. Judging from our present state, they have succeeded in imprinting in us a sense of being separate, yet we are in fact one people. While our leaders fight, the European Union is removing continental borders and making sure that they join currencies to create a much stronger one. While our leaders fight and while we sleep, China is gradually taking over the world through technology, drive, innovation, and discipline. The sad thing is that Africa has as much talent, but because of extremely bad leadership, poverty has become one of the synonyms of our continent. While our leaders continue to insult each other, millions of Africans continue to go to bed hungry because very little economic growth and development has occurred in Africa in the last couple of decades. While egos continue to clash in many African parliaments, many young people continue to commit suicide because they see zero hope in their future. The Pan-African Parliament is one of the key organs of the AU, but just like the AU itself, it is proving to be a forum of fools in suits.